This is an idea that comes from a famous story in politics, a very famous story. It might even be true. In the early 1960s, Clare Booth Lewis, who was one of the first women to serve in the U.S. Congress, supposedly came into a very young President Kennedy and said, "Mr. President, you don't understand something significant about leadership. You don't understand," she said, "that a great man is a sentence." Kennedy, what does that mean? She said, anybody who's ever, well, update it, great person is a sentence. Anybody who's ever achieved anything in their lives isn't trying to do 97 different things, but is trying to do one or two big transcendent things. So she said Abraham Lincoln had a sentence. He preserved the Union and freed the slaves. FDR had a sentence. He lifted us out of a Great Depression and helped us win a world war. She said, Mr. President, you don't have a sentence. You have a muddled paragraph. You're trying to do 17 things, and as a result, you're not doing anything. And I think it's a very instructive tale for leaders of every kind, whether you're leading a school, whether you're leading a coaching a team, whether you're leading a company. And it's a good exercise, I think, for individuals to find their purpose. So I ask people, you know, describe your sentence. What's your sentence? When it's all said and done, what's it about?
I think it's important before you get started to make sure that everyone has a voice in what's going on, because if they feel like you're being told what to do, then less people are going to buy in. So the goal from the beginning was to give everybody a voice and to engage everyone and try to hear everyone's voice.
We talked about where we had been at Downey High School over the years, and we were going so many different ways. There was, you know, No Child Left Behind, and then Common Core, and all of these things, and Avid, and we were going so many different directions that basically we're losing our focus. And what's our focus? To help our students become the best and most productive citizens ever, right? So we showed a movie, a clip from a movie, City Slickers, in which Curly tells Mitch that, you know what, you're going crazy, all these different directions. Just be known for one thing. Choose one thing in your life that you want to be known for.
Do you know what the secret of life is?
No, what?
This.
Your finger?
One thing. Just one thing. You stick to that and everything else don't mean.
That's great, but what's the one thing?
That's what you gotta figure out.
We engage the staff into coming up with the one thing by making a professional day. All the staff sat in the gym and the question was posed to them, what is it about Downey High School? What a Downey High School can the students leave Downey High School saying, I am fill in the blank. What does Downey High School provide for students, basically? There was some discussion as to what that one focus is. What is that one thing that Downey High School represents? There were posters set up around the gym. They had different numbers set up on them. One, ein, uno, un. All these different languages, different symbols. But the idea was, what is the one thing that we represent? So the staff was divided into little groups, which had a discussion. Every group had somebody from each department representing their subject. And what is that one thing that, it doesn't matter what subject you teach, that we can instill in the students? So the discussion opened up, they wrote it down on the posters.
So we had pieces of butcher paper all in the gym, and people went around the room and wrote what they thought was the one focus that they thought would be best for Downey High School. And the teachers walked around and we got all these ideas. And over the course of things, one thing stood out. We had a lot of people saying we want our students to be able to think critically, to problem shoot, and think of creative solutions to, like, climate problems and cancer and all these things that are affecting us as a global society. We want our students to be able to think critically, to come up with some solutions for these problems, because our students are our future.
After that, we came together as an ILT and we looked at all of the responses and we started putting them into different categories. And a lot of different responses could be fit into one category or another. A lot of them were either college and career, or it was critical thinking, or it was reading, or it was writing. So we started kind of categorizing each of the ideas and pretty much came up with those four, and then decided, okay, now it seems like, because we gave staff a lot of time to comment on some of the ideas in on posters and lounges, and then it seemed like most people were in favor of critical thinking or writing, and we then had to figure out how to choose between the two, but then it was suggested that perhaps we merge the two, because it's really hard to just prove how is someone critically thinking. Well, they're able to prove it now via their writing.
It's crucial as a school that you include students. They're great minds, they're human, they're young, they're curious, and they want to be part of something.
Once we came up with critical thinking through writing to get students involved in helping us come up with our zippy slogan, and every second period teacher as a class, they could come up with a zippy slogan, and then they posted that on the doors outside of their classroom so everybody could see, oh, what's that slogan for that classroom and that slogan.
Yellow Downey High School.
I think he means hello, Downey High School.
I'm Eric Navas.
And I'm Hector Gonzalez. And we are here to discuss some important information that everyone needs to be aware about here at Downey High.
Hector, have you heard about our school-wide focus?
Yes, I have. It's critical thinking through writing. This is the one thing that all students need to be able to do upon graduation.
Right now, our school is deciding on one slogan or catchphrase that will remind us all about critical thinking through writing.
Right now? Good one, Eric. Now let's look at some of the submissions. Some really good options there. Which one do you like, Eric?
I'm not really sure right now.
Okay, Eric. It was funny the first time.
And then students again voted on the zippy slogans for the class, and eventually we just whittled it down, and came up with Think with Ink.
Thank you.
Okay, so we went to the PLCs with an idea of what should we do first to involve the students? Which teaching practice are we going to do first? And we got several ideas from the departments, and so we gathered those ideas together and tried to look for a theme and tried to look for something that was pretty broad, because every teaching discipline is going to do it, from PE to English and science and math, social studies, the whole gamut. And so that's how we determined that justification is going to be our starting point.
I'm Punxsutawney Phil. You may have seen or even heard about me before. I'm the groundhog that people come to see on February 2nd. These fine gentlemen holding me are my handlers. Meet John and Ben.
Well, being a handler is one of the most important jobs that there is when it comes to groundhogs and Groundhog Day and Punxsutawney.
Well, I always say we're the men behind the hog.
You'll have to excuse me, I'm a little groggy. I usually hibernate from October until you see me in early February. John and Ben are pretty good about making sure I get my beauty sleep, because in the spring, my schedule sure is jam-packed.
We coordinate his daily schedule and his schedule with either school groups or meetings all over the country, all over the state. He's a pretty busy guy.
Busy doesn't even begin to describe it. I mean, it's not easy having to tell the world whether there'll be 6 more weeks of winter or an early spring.
The entire school rolling out the justification best practice, and complete with the staff's gonna have t-shirts on or polo shirts, and we're gonna make it a big reintroduction to the justification and Think with Ink and the whole process of critical thinking through writing. So we're trying to regain some momentum now.
The agency is a group of students led by Mr. Herrera, who designed a logo for the school-wide focus Think with Ink. I was the people person. I presented all the ideas to the teachers, and I talked about what we changed and what we needed to be changed for each logo design that we presented.
My part in it was to mock it up and to look as if it's right in front of your face. So if it's like on a wall, instead of it just being like a really blurry picture, it will look like it's right there in front of you.
See, me, I help him, like we're partners in this. And I mainly help him with the logos, help him touch it up maybe a little bit, and yeah.
What was the process of making the logo?
The process was a very long process. We had been on this project for almost 2.5 months. The process, it started out with just an illustration, and then we turned it into something that can be branded into many things. It could be branded onto a wall, and a banner, on a window, on a flyer, on a file, notebook. It could be branded on a lot of things. And with the process took so long that it's become a thing that would be around Downey so much that people would just know instantly what it is.
Important concept for students because it shows how writing is a very important idea that we have to use in our everyday life, how our thoughts should be able to be written and we should be able to express them through writing.
Why are we doing all this? For the betterment of our students, so our students can be competitive global citizens. This is why we're doing it. All these activities and why the ILT was formed, so our students will have productive lives.